Tabs are a fundamental part of modern user interfaces. They help organize information efficiently, making it easy for users to switch between different content sections. If you think about your favorite website or app, chances are it uses tabs to streamline the user experience. In today's video, we will create interactive tabs that look sleek and modern, with a cool sliding marker to indicate which one is active, and we will do it all without relying on JavaScript. Let's get started. We begin with a simple HTML page and add a container for the tab component. Inside, we will create two separate areas for tabs and tab contents. Our tabs will be based on a set of radio inputs and labels to create the functionality. An input element of type radio will act as a switch between active and inactive states. A unique ID for each radio button, like overview in this case, will tie them with their corresponding label. And a common name attribute will group all input elements together. To make the first tab the default active tab, we will add the checked attribute to its radio button. Similarly, the content area will have a separate div for each tab, and a unique class attribute will help us select them easily in our CSS. Let me quickly add the rest of the HTML, and then we can shift our focus to the style sheet. The CSS file is ready with all the foundational styles we need for the project. So let's dive into making these tabs look amazing. The first step is to style the parent block. We aren't doing anything too fancy here, just some straightforward CSS rules to set the stage. To make our tabs line up perfectly, we turn the parent element into a flex container with a defined height and a bottom border. This will give us better control over how the tabs are spaced and aligned. Because we want to create a custom look for our tabs, we can simply hide the radio buttons and use their corresponding labels to create a visual appearance and control their behavior without worrying about the default button styles. For the labels, the flex property with the value of 1 will assign them an equal width. Moving forward, these can also act as a flex container so that their text can be centered perfectly. Now let's make them look good with some presentational styles. To highlight the currently selected tab, we can use the checked pseudo-class combined with the adjacent sibling combinator. It's like saying, if a radio button inside the tab's container is checked, meaning it's selected, then change the color of the label that comes right after. Now let's work on the active tab marker. We will use the after pseudo element on the tab's CSS class. Since we are positioning it absolutely, it requires the content property, which is an empty string. The inset property set to 0 is like combining all four sides, top, right, bottom, and left, in a single CSS shorthand. Then we add the width along with some aesthetics for the marker. It seems to cover the entire viewport. This is because an absolutely positioned element needs a relative parent. We can fix it by adding position relative to the tabs class. It also needs the z-index with a value of -1 to layer it down in the stacking order. However, it appears gone at the far bottom of the stack. Since the widget class has a white background, the marker becomes invisible. A simple solution to fix this is adding the isolation property. The isolation property in CSS determines whether an element's content is rendered in its own stacking context or not. Stacking context deals with how elements are layered on top of each other on a web page, especially concerning the Z-axis. If you are interested in learning more about isolation, we have a short video explaining how and where we can use it to create different blending effects. As it is anchored with the parent element instead of the individual tabs, we need to adjust its width. Currently, it covers 100% of the space, but we know the number of tabs we have, so we can easily calculate the required width. Here we are using the calc function to figure out the final width of a tab, which is 1/3 of the container's width minus 2 pixels for the left and right sides of borders. And then we can slightly update the inset property to hide the bottom border for the designated area. To make our marker follow the active tab, we'll use a CSS variable. This will hold a value that represents the position of the active tab, which by default is 0. Actually, add another variable to store the number of tabs. It will be easier to maintain in the future, since we wouldn't want to mess around with the formula. Coming back to our active tab variable, when a tab is clicked, we will update it based on the index of the click tab. What is happening here is, We are using the has pseudo class to determine if the first radio button is checked. If it is, then set the active variable to 0. Similarly, if it is the second button, then set it to 1, and so on. This updated value will then be used to position the marker accordingly. The translate property can utilize the calc function to figure out its position on the x-axis. So if it is the first tab, then 0 multiplied by 100% will be 0%, which is the starting position of the first tab. Then 100% is the starting point for the second tab, and 200% is the starting point for the third one. After that, we add the transition to animate the change. By dynamically changing the active variable, we can create a smooth and responsive sliding marker effect. Then comes the tab content. The first thing that we need to do is hide it by default. Basically, we are telling the browser to hide any element whose class name starts with tab content. This is a neat trick to hide all our tab content areas at once without having to write a separate rule for each. Then, once again, we use the has pseudo class to determine the active tab and make its corresponding content visible. We have another video explaining why it's been a highly anticipated feature in the world of CSS and how we can leverage its capabilities to enhance our CSS workflow. Feel free to check it out. To wrap up, we have just built a sleek, interactive tab component from scratch using only HTML and CSS. By understanding the power of radio buttons, labels, and CSS pseudo classes, we can create a dynamic element that can be customized to match any design style. This project showcases the versatility of web development and the ability to create engaging user interfaces. The key to effective UI design is simplicity and clarity. These tabs are a prime example of how to achieve both. So go forth and experiment with different styles, colors, and layouts to create your own unique tab components. Share your experience and ideas in the comments below. Give this video a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe for more coding adventures. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one.